Who knew? Who knew that I can have a peaceful afternoon all to myself? For once!
Such a beautiful... I get those things, eh? You wait for me.
Okay, I think I spoke too soon. Who are you? Yeah.
How are you?
I'm fine. Who are you?
I'm a businessman.
You're a businessman?
What's going on? I don't know. I'll explain later. This is good business, by the way. Let me check it down here.
You're a businessman? You know that could be your father, and I'm about to be shocked. Nothing surprises me these days. What is he? Jed, what is he?
That's
our dish.
I'll explain. Wait, this is a good
Jed,
business. Scrub for cash.
Pardon?
Scrub for cash.
Excuse me, please. Stop making noise. Scrub for who?
For cash.
What does that mean?
They take metal, they give us money.
How much money? Don't tell me that you're going to make money.
How much is the key?
2,000.
Boss, you told me 2,000 plus. Yes, a kilo of scrap
is 2,000.
Yeah, no, 7,000. Is that not what you've been telling me the other side?
7,000, 2,000.
No, okay. 7.
Yeah.
7,000.
Yeah.
Okay.
When's the white one?
Please, Jared, no. Stop taking me on speed of
writing. I think this is the best idea.
Best idea?
We're getting money.
How many kilos are in this? How many kilos can we get in this?
Let me add another. There's a white one.
Young man, how many kilos
can we get from that? Like, well, 1.5 to 2.
See?
1.5 kilos and you're taking my saucepans. Do you know how much these saucepans are?
Who bought them?
What do you mean who bought? Jared, what is this? You want to sell saucepans that are higher value because they make 1 kilogram of scrap.
Yeah, but you need money and think this is the best opportunity for us to make money and get rich.
To sell all our saucepans?
Yes.
So that you get 2,000, 7,000.
7,000. You can enjoy meat.
We can enjoy meat. How do I cook food when you've taken all the saucepans? So how am I supposed to cook food?
We can maybe roast it.
Roast what? So, I'm going to roast and even roast the soup. So now we are going to be roasting everything. We'll roast soup.
No, you see now that's a bit of having money. We go to a restaurant.
How much money are we talking about? 7,000 for saucepans.
No, every day we'll be getting metals, windows, what? Then money will be coming.
Yes.
Let me tell you, this is the best idea. I've never heard of anything like
Jared,
this.
Jared, you know what? I'm sorry. I'm the one who is supposed to apologize. I forced you to go and look for a job. I keep telling you we should have money. Every idea you come up with leaves me speechless. So I want to sell our valuable saucepan for a scrap of 7,000. What kind of carriage?
Okay, don't have money. We are getting money.
No, you're giving away our valuable saucepans for nothing. Sir, please go. Get out of here. You want to sell our saucepans, things which are valuable. That's a dish that we got. We haven't even used it for long.
I think these are business ideas. Now, look, metals.
Jared, you know what? Stop. It's okay. It's all right. It's all right. It's okay. I don't earn the money in this house. It's okay. Don't earn anything. Who said this was going to be a good day? I spoke too soon.
Is that right?
It's okay. Ranch from where? So assuming the rest of these saucepans, ranch from where? Where would I have gotten it from? Nana Gerardi, Nana, stop making my head spin. Okay, leave the things of searching for a job, it's alright. Let me just know that I will be the one searching for jobs in this house. Scrap! Scrap! Aren't you going to remove our door for security and say it will be a way to have scrap? 1 kilogram at home, what is wrong with
you? I'm trying to get money.
because you are landlord.
You are landlord. You mean because you are my landlord, you don't have mad. Get down. Get down, please. Down, no. Down, and down there. Uh-huh. What is your problem? How are you?
You hear that? How are you? I've come. I'm here to pick my money.
How did you enter the gate?
Sure. Of course, I'm the landlord.
I have the spare key.
You have the spare key?
Yes.
So you also have the spare key of this house?
What do you mean?
I don't understand why you keep telling me about rent. Do you know how I'm suffering to stay in this house? Do you know that your house reeks? I'm actually helping you. No one else would afford to stay in this house. Do you know that it reeks? Do you know that the roof reeks?
Is it leaking?
Yes, it has.
Okay, let's go.
You think I'm stupid that would let it leak? I'm a DNC. I cannot find a solution. I'd be there waiting for you to come and be my savior. Do you know how much chewing gum I've eaten to block the ceiling so that it doesn't rain? How much chewing gum that is? Do you know what danger that poses to my teeth? As if that is not the only problem. Have you seen that grass there? Do you know how many snakes are in that grass that is in the compound? Have you ever come here to cut the grass and reduce on the stress that you are causing me? Do you know that it harbors snakes? I get nightmares in the night waiting for snakes. Anacondas to pass and enter my house and kill me. And do you think you can pay me for that one? When we begin paying in terms of pay, do you know how many mosquitoes are in this house? It's like I'm staying in a bush. I am staying in a... It's like I'm having lullabies throughout the whole night. I don't sleep. And you're telling me to pay you. As if that is not enough. Why didn't you contact me when you were going to put tiles in this house? Do you know that I slid the other day and I broke my arm? Do you know that I broke my hand in the bathroom the other day? I used to stretch it very faster. Touch it. Touch it. You can't even smell it. You can't even smell it. I've been putting liniment, trying to straighten my arm. I've not been working for just about... You even reminded me.
So now you are trying to say that I'm now your father, so that I should start treating you, your family, whenever...
You seem to be thinking I am stupid. How much money do you want me to pay you by now?
For the last 3 months, something like 470.
What do you mean? What do you mean for the last 3 months? I was in the village for 2 months. I was in Kabale for 2 months.
So you mean when you were in Kabale, nobody was sleeping?
Absolutely. Which means I cannot pay you for that money. So let's do this. Let me help you. I'm going to give you the phone number of my landlord in Kabale.
For what?
He will refund you for those 2 months I was staying there. Do you know a man called Mujema?
I don't know.
He has your money. Because he's the one I paid for those 2 months when I was in Kabale. I cannot pay double. I am not as if I can't be in two places. I can give you his phone number. The two of you agree who will pay who. You told me you have a key to the gate, right?
As a landlord.
You can also open my house. So you have entered my house at some point. Eh? That changes our relationship. It is no longer a tenant landlord relationship. We are rather housemates.
What do you mean there?
You're supposed to be paying also rent. Because Katinkubanja. Because you enter my house when I'm not around. Who knows for how long you slept in my house for those 2 months I was not around. So as I am speaking right now, You're supposed to be paying me money. Do you know that? Do you know that your house is not very comfortable, that I want to be in it? If you paid me the house, the money that you're supposed to give me, I would get out of the house and leave it for you. The next time before you come here, trying to stress me on a weekend, think about what you're talking about. Because I was cheating. It is a Sunday. It's Sunday morning. I'm not supposed to be stressing like this. Get out of my house. Get out of my house. You leave.